It's just a phase I'm going through. Part 2. Welcome to Stargazers. I'm James Albury, director of the Kika Silva Pla Planetarium in Gainesville, Florida.
And I'm Dean Regas, astronomer for the Cincinnati Observatory. You may remember that 2 weeks ago, I asked James a question about what phase the moon would be in if it rose at noon.
Yep, I got it right too.
Yes, you did. So, ready for another one?
Sure.
Okay, if the moon sets at noon, what phase is it in?
Oh, another easy one. It would be at last quarter.
Right again.
Thank you, thank you. So, how did I know that?
He's a witch!
No, not really. But we'll show you how I answered that question, and we have a really cool Mars moon and Saturn moon scoochie next week as well. Let's show you. When we talked 2 weeks ago about the phases of the moon, we mentioned that it takes about a week for the moon to go from one major phase to the next. For example, if the moon is in the new phase on July 26th, it will be at first quarter on August 4th.
When the moon is at first quarter, it's traveled a quarter of the way around the Earth, and therefore it's 90 degrees east of the sun in the sky. So the moon rises just as the sun is reaching its highest point in the sky at noon.
Then, a week after that, on August 10th, the moon is in its full phase, and it's 180 degrees away from the sun. This means that the moon will rise as the sun sets, and it will set as the sun rises. In the days following the full moon, we begin to see less and less of the daytime side of the moon and more of the nighttime side. These are called the waning phases. Waning means to get smaller, and the moon is appearing humped again, so we call this the waning gibbous moon.
On August 17th, it will have been a week since the full moon, which is now 3 weeks after the new moon. The moon has traveled 3/4 of the way around the Earth, so we call this phase last quarter. We again see half of the daylit side and half of the nighttime side, but reversed from what we saw at first quarter on August 4th. The moon is also visible in the early morning instead of the early evening.
In this configuration, the moon is now 270 degrees east of the sun, or, less confusingly, 90 degrees west of the sun. So when the sun is at its highest point in the sky at noon, the moon will be setting on the western horizon.
Lastly, we have the waning crescent phase. This occurs during the last week of the moon's orbit around the Earth, and we see the daylit side shrink more and more as the days pass.
On August 25th, 29 days after the beginning of the moon's journey, the moon is back where it started, in a position putting it between the Earth and the sun. The moon is new once again.
All right, with that said, let's check out our moon planet scoochies. Okay, we have our skies set up for Friday, August 1st, just after sunset, facing southwest. You'll see a waxing crescent moon just to the right of Spica, the brightest star in the constellation Virgo the Maiden. If you notice, the moon, Spica, Mars, and Saturn form an almost straight line in the sky, leading you towards Scorpius the Scorpion.
Advancing time one day to Saturday, August 2nd, you'll see the waxing crescent moon snuggled nicely between the red planet Mars and the bright star Spica. Mars is the reddish, non-twinkling light to the moon's left, and Spica will be the bright blue twinkling light to the moon's right.
Then, on the following evening, Sunday, August 3rd, the moon has moved another 13 degrees in the sky, placing it between the ring planet Saturn and the Roman god of war, Mars.
Lastly, let's advance time one more day to Monday, August 4th, and we now have a first quarter moon, just to the east of our celestial trio. So, let's run through that again. Friday, August 1st, Saturday, August 2nd, Sunday, August 3rd, and Monday, August 4th.
Oh, and by the way, around lunchtime, check out the eastern horizon on Monday, August 4th. Guess what you'll see?
The moon.
Exactly. Keep looking up.